What's up, man? You know what it is. It's your boy, Chamillionaire, Houston's own mixtape messiah. Right now, you're tuning into my BET official DVD from my album, Ultimate Victory. You just bought the album. Hopefully, you're feeling it. Now, I know you're feeling it because it's that fire. You know what I'm talking about? What we're finna do today is I'm finna take you through the whole journey from beginning of my role when people was calling me Chamillionaire till now. When I'm a Grammy award-winning artist, you know what I mean? Platinum records, platinum ringtones, a lot of awards, everything I went through to get here, man, the whole grind, the whole hustle, you know what it is. You're in the presence of the finest, your boy Chamillionaire, Camilla Terry, man. That's the name that's running the game. Kick back, get some popcorn, kick your feet up, kick it with your boy, BET, that's what it is.
You know what, you have the right to remain stupid, boy. They always try to ruin you.
I want to get on the mixtape. Everywhere I was going, fans was like, they go to mixtape messiah.
I got some mixtapes. I know they get down real heavy out here.
That's a powerful statement to say the mixtape messiah.
So for those of you that don't know, you better know what my name is.
I call myself King Cooper. Come here, Terry, man.
It's your boy, Chamillionaire, the mixtape messiah.
That's definitely my claim to fame.
He went from hustling mixtapes and riding dirty all the way to the Grammy.
They hating, patrolling, and trying to catch me riding dirty.
I knew the record was hot, man. The monster. Platinum records, platinum ringtones, a lot of awards.
This is the real appreciation. I appreciate it for real.
Houston has had its own style and its own culture for a long time.
Baby, I see you every time with a new chain around your neck.
This is my weekend jewelry, you know what I'm saying?
People wasn't even up on it. It was just a good feeling, man, to see that support. BET was there. They were showing love. They were messing with me with the camera and all that.
I just want to say, you know, thanks to BET for even showing me all this love like this.
My name is Chamillionaire, Houston's own mixtape messiah. Name Chamillionaire, basically, you know, I used to be Chameleon, you know what I'm saying? That was before the millionaire part came, you know what I'm saying? Some people look at it like chameleon, some people look at it like millionaire, but basically, if you put the words together, it just means the artist that's rich in style. A lot of people that know I rap fast, I sing the hook, I do whatever, rapping a Texas style, whatever, you know what I'm saying? Chameleon is a lizard like this. It's a real lizard that changes colors and is different than all the rest of the lizards, you know what I'm saying? That's like me as an artist, different than all the rest of the artists. So Chamillionaire, that fit me perfectly, you know what I'm saying? Chamillionaire, man, for all my fans that like know my mixtape grind when I was doing mixtapes, I used to be, man, saying so many different ways to show you how you were balling. You know, I could say my rims is bigger than your seventh grade brother, and just the fans used to love all the little ways I was telling them how rich I was and how much balling I was. And even though I was making a little money, you know what I'm saying, now that I got like real money, I look back at some of that stuff and I'd be like, man, it seems silly, you know what I'm saying? So I started wanting to have a purpose behind the name because people always thought I was just about, you know, just materialistic stuff. And fans was like, oh, he's one-dimensional. You know, a lot of people sit there and complain because Chamillionaire has grown and he kind of tries different things and stuff like that. But back in the day when I was doing all that stuff, even though it was working, people were like, man, he's one-dimensional. They always gonna complain about you regardless. So I just want to have some purpose behind my name, if anything, so I added the millionaire part. I used to be just Chamillion, and I added the millionaire, and the millionaire means rich in style. You know, a chameleon changes colors and adapts, and I'll rap fast, rap slow, sing the hook, get on a street song, get on a pop song. You know, I'm just all over the place, but at the same time, you know, blending in very, very well, and that's what Chamillionaire means. You know, the mixtape thing definitely was like, people gotta remember, I came from promotions and marketing. That's what I was doing before I even, you know, got onto the mixtape circuit. So I already knew the power in advertising and promoting and marketing. And with the mixtape, that was the best form of promotion in the streets. You know, people was bootlegging them, people was downloading it. It was the easiest way to build a hype. And back in the days in Texas, you know, they had the Swisher House mixtapes and the Chopped and Screwed mixtapes, and, you know, the screw music was the big, you know, culture or form out there, and I was just seeing it. At first, I didn't really understand it. I was just looking, but I noticed everybody was messing with it. So it's almost like you gotta find a way to study. You gotta get in here, you know? And I knew what I had to do. Some people be so anti-everything that they don't even get nowhere. And I wanted to get on the mixtapes, and it started off with a couple freestyles, and next thing you know, people started, you know, asking more about me, and I started building a fan base. You know, even back in the days when I used to be in a group with Paul Wall, you know, we were just building a fan base, getting bigger and bigger, and then next thing you know, independent albums come out where I'm selling 100,000 plus, you know what I mean? And then just building a big core audience, not
through Texas, but everywhere. People was like, oh, you got a big fan base in Houston and Texas, but, you know, I was doing shows in Cleveland, doing shows in Denver, a lot of places, you know, and that was as an independent artist. So the mixtape's definitely the best form of promotion online, in the streets, everywhere.
It's your boy, Chamillionaire, Houston's own mixtape messiah. Right now, you're tuned into Rap City.
That's a powerful statement to say the mixtape messiah, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, I made my whole living off of mixtapes, and that's how I built up a fan base before all this major label thing happened, before all these awards and all of the Hollywood stuff. You know, it's a mixtape, so that's definitely my claim to fame, you know? We got fans in Denver and Cleveland and everywhere, you know what I'm saying? And the mixtapes did that, you know? Like even when you get major and you start making money, you still got to respect that streets.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? And that's what the mixtapes do for you. So we put the mixtapes in the streets to kind of like, you know, keep that buzz hot in the streets, because a lot of these people that's really buying these mixtapes don't even really pay attention to all that, you know, that mainstream stuff.
See, the thing about it is, when you're in a screw shop, it's like, you gotta come in here and spend some money, man. This is like history. History in the making, man. I feel just good being in here knowing that this is the, like, where it all started at. You know what I'm saying? They help a young person like me to get on, you know what I'm saying, and do what I'm doing now. So it's like giving back to them for, like, thanks. You know what I'm saying? Coming in, it seems small, like buying a CD or buying a tape, but you gotta do that, man. You gotta support the hood. You gotta put it back in, you know what I'm saying?
A lot of people know me from being in a group with Paul Wall and just, you know, being down with Swisher House and being down with different companies and stuff like that. And, you know, it's like almost a family thing, you know? You know, every family has its problems and every family's not gonna all see eye to eye, you know? And I think, so for so many years, you can look at all the groups in history, you know, that done broke up or whatever, people always expect them to be on the same page the whole course. And that's not necessarily the case, but what we've grown now to understand is that it's really just smart for us not to be beefing, you know what I mean? We have to agree to disagree. And that's what we decided to do. But it took a little while for everybody just to mature to understand that, you know? Like, everybody's past that. Some people got kids, you know, I don't, but some people got kids, some people got family, and, you know, you start to get older and start to be more into this entertainment industry, and then you start to, you know, really realize what's stupid and what's not, you know? And I think that's why, you know, everybody in Texas basically just set all the problems to side, all the little bickering. You know that saying they say that, you know, from a distance, two people arguing and both just look like idiots. You know, we just kind of put all the stuff to the side. I don't have no problems with nobody from Texas. I'm trying to do my thing, you know? I'm grinding and they grinding too, you know? What is it about Houston? Houston, I feel like, has had its own style and its own, you know, I guess, you know, just culture for a long time, and people wasn't even up on it, you know?
We were sitting back watching all the other coasts do it. You had the West Coast on top, then it went over to the East, and then it went back to the West. And we was just sitting waiting for our time, and then, you know, you had people that came through like Master P and Cash Money and a lot of people that started, you know, getting on from the South. So people started giving the South a chance. And then it started breaking all different types of places in the South. And now I feel like people got the spotlight on Houston and they're giving us a chance. It's our time to run with it.
And also it's went through different phases, you know, because you had the veterans and the OGs, like the Scarface and the Ghetto Boys that was doing their thing. And then now Houston has kind of developed a sound. It knows its identity now, you know what I mean? So now it's just kind of blowing up to the masses and everybody's like, you know what, I like that, you know? Turn It Up was basically my warm-up record for my album. And I don't want to say warm-up because, you know, I went to Scott Storch, and, you know, Scott Storch is a highly respected producer in the game and, you know, definitely a veteran that's been doing it for a long time and making a lot of hits. And, you know, I went to him and I was like, you know, the A&Rs actually sent me over there, you know. And at first I was like, I don't know, man. I don't know if I'm gonna mess with this guy, man, Scott Storch. And I went and he was cool, man. I was in the studio with him and we was vibing. And
Scott Storch, he don't even play a whole bunch of beats for you. He just play one beat and he'd be like, this is yours, you know what I'm saying? So I met him out there in Miami at the Hit Factory and he had a banger for me and he played the beat and it was just beating so hard, you know what I'm saying? That's how we like it. In Texas, we big on the trunk game, you know what I'm saying? So your trunk gotta be rattling.
He actually took the time to listen to my mixtapes. Like, he listened to my mixtapes, he was listening to my hooks and all the stuff, and he's like, you know what? I think you got some of the dopest melodies, you know what I mean? But on this record, I want you to just simplify it just a little bit. You know what I'm saying? I was just like, that was cool to hear him at least give me his advice on how he wanted me to do it. And, you know, I did the record originally, and I was just trying so hard to spit so crazy on it. And he was just like, nah, just simplify it a little bit. You know what I mean? Just a little bit more. And I simplified it. And after that, I was like, I can't simplify it more than this, because if I do, I'm going to be freestyling. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I was like, it's like, each other meeting each other halfway, and it was kind of like the goal was to get something to where you wouldn't gonna go over people's heads. You know, a lot of people honestly don't know you in the mainstream right now, and people are gonna instantly be like, oh, you got a Scott Storch beat, you know what I mean? And radio's gonna think about it like that, and that's definitely what happened. You know, when the record went out, we put Flip on it, and we was going everywhere doing shows, and every time it came on, the crowd was just bouncing, and I sold 500,000 records and got a gold plaque.
Give me that $1 million beat and let me show you what to do with it. Who that is? That's the illest rapper chopped and screwing okay. It. Couldn't snatch the game is what they told me, so I'm proving it. Put the truth in Texas with Scott Storch and you got you a hit.
This is like my first major label video, you know what I mean? And I got, you know, Flip showed up, you know what I'm saying? He was on point, you know?
Man, I've been messing with Chamillion since my first album on Sony, you know. He was on the track How You See It, and you know, I always mess with people that stay humble and, you know, don't get a little fame and think they better than everybody. So every time he called me, I'ma be there, you know what I'm saying? And when I call him, he does. So that's how we sitting on this couch. So go get the underground legend, you go hear him on, you see him singing the hook. And that's how we connect, man.
And everything went smooth, you know, and we was at the set, and it was good for me because, like, Manny Fresh and a lot of people came to the set, Bun B, and just people came and showed me a lot of support. And to me, that was real cool, man. The whole city, it came out. And that just showed me, you know, because a lot of times when you go to the majors, people instantly will either love you or completely hate you. And there was a lot of love, man. We put it together to where, you know, we show a little Texas culture, you know, the candy red car to this day. People are still talking about that candy red lac, you know. And I don't even own it no more. Pimp C bought it from me, so that's kind of cool, man.
I'ma show you how to get your shine on.
We at my video shoot for The Sound of Revenge, you know what I'm saying? This is the first single off of my album. It's called Turn It Up, featuring Lil Flip. And, you know, this is a Texas banger produced by Scott Storch. You know what I'm saying? We just came out here to show the whole Texas culture with a cinematic flair. My man Gil Green, he shoot a video for me, so we're gonna try to do it big out here in Texas, man.
And come so, so. Action.
What they talking about, baby? Already.
Cut it.
Hey, what's up? This is Gil Green, director with Chamillionaire.
Already.
And basically we're gonna shoot the opening of this video. And when me and Chamillionaire were talking, basically, he wanted to make sure that he got the dialogue of Houston in it. So right from the beginning, you're gonna catch the flavor of their slang and how they talk down here. So that's basically the idea of this shot.
Already.
Tell me about it.
Hey man, in Texas, you know what I'm saying? We talk with a lot of slang, real Southern accent, and a lot of times people end the conversation with already.
Already.
Already. Already. That's how we end it. So that's what I'm getting into. That's real easy for me because that's natural for me. So. Already.
We just finished up wrapping all our driving shots, and this gave us a little bit of flavor of the hood of Houston. You know, it's basically Chamillionaire driving around, and we've seen a few vignettes of what's going on in Houston, the swinging, the cars, you know, so, you know, North Side cast, the South Side cast. There's a whole culture down here that the world is being exposed to. Right now, we're gonna do a car wash scene.
Getting ready to do the car wash scene. This is the scene where I stand in front of the candy red slab. H-Shine is crying. We got the ladies cleaning the car. Each one is a candy-coated vehicle, you know? This is the way it is out here, man. Everybody ride candy, and we just gonna represent it to the fullest, you know what I'm saying? To the extreme. Right here, the candy paint, the gold. And I'm finna just do my thing, my cameo thing. You know how I get down. Like a natural. Showing the diamonds. Real smooth, like real gangster.
Super producer Scott Storch and the course.